Good morning, everyone. And it's an honor to be here with you all and delivering this speech on the commencement of innovative business practice. When I see you all, my mind turns to the first days of my university life. So, you guys made the right choice because you chose one of the top three universities in Victoria. And you guys are lucky much. I'll tell you later why is that so. To be honest, I was scared. But deep down, I had a lot of hopes and dreams. I hope you and you have the same. Then, Swinburne became home for me, but I always believed Swinburne will guide me through many more great things, not just a degree, not just academic values. Today, standing here in front of you, delivering this speech is one of the examples for that. Let me ask you a question. Do you have dreams? I know all of you have, even though you don't like to show up. So now you are university students, so don't call it a dream anymore. Make it a plan. When you become university students, you start to think logically. You start to work harder. You start to maximize your social circle. But working harder would not be helpful if you don't work hard for the right direction. Maximizing your social circle would not be helpful if you don't gain opportunities and the motivation from the right people around you. Then we face the most important hurdle in our lives. How do we find the correct path? What should we have to do to get there? Well, that's the journey you have to travel through alone. The difference between who you are today and who you're going to be in the future is all about what you do. But don't copy someone else, because if you copy someone else, you won't be successful, because there is no one else became successful copying another person. Unless you lose yourself, you lose your originality. And also, not to mention, a balanced social and academic life. But there is very experienced people around us to guide us and give us good advices and open up opportunities and empower with you your knowledge. Most of these opportunities are around us, the volunteering program, clubs and societies, Swinburne Student Life, and more importantly, our emerging leader program. I was selected as the president of Swinburne Sri Lankan Student Association. Afterwards, I became a student volunteer. Then gradually I became a volunteer leader. With my leadership experience, then afterwards I became a swim mentor. Then after that, I became the first emerging leader to achieve all the 8 skills and win all 8 awards, which she showed you earlier. then that guided me to become emerging leader ambassador. When Swinburne recognizes you as an emerging leader, it will state on your academic transcript in the first page, even before your grade. So if you do these programs, it will guide you to gain more skills which you cannot learn from just subject outlines in your academic class, like teamwork and collaboration, tackle unfamiliar problems, adapt different situations. In reality, the employers are looking for more than just a good academic transcript, but the skills which you can use in actual working field, in your office environment or anywhere you work, they're looking for those skills. As a student, I listen to my mentors and lecturers, which led me to be employed by my very first interview. Today I'm working with Australia's largest companies and different states. There's a huge difference between literacy and education. Anyone can be literate, but you have to be someone special to be educated. I said you guys are lucky bunch. That's because Dr. Andreessen is not just a lecturer. He's a multi-talented person. He's a management consultant, a coach, an educator, and the founding director of consulting company. Those are only few of his talents which I found in Google. Because I only have a few minutes to do this speech. So you don't have to look too far for the opportunities, as he can offer you industry involvement opportunities, internships, and professional placements. I hope everyone will build a ladder to your life goals by grasping those opportunities. Remember, there is nothing worse than losing a chance which you can change your life, which you can become successful. First, you have to recognize who you are, then the hard part. You have to accept and adapt to who you are. That's where most people will fail. Finally, you have to be comfortable with your decisions and the outcome, because there's nothing in a caterpillar going to say it's going to be a butterfly unless someone have believed in it. But remember, my friends, your success will not be harm or suffering to anyone else. Be humble, be a person who down to earth, help each other, help everyone else as much as you can, and leave your legacy as a fingerprint of your soul, unique and distinct. Wherever we go, whatever we do, we always belong to Swinburne family. You and me always belong to Swinburne family. So don't hesitate to contact me for any advice or any help, as I am always willing to represent Mother Swinburne. Thank you.